Hello, aspirants. Looking at current affairs for 27 September, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these 12. We'll look at them in detail. The first one, Army strikes Naga militants along Myanmar border. So this is regarding the attack which took place. The army has inflicted heavy casualty on NSC and K militants. So this was an operation conducted close to the Myanmar border. So it was here, you can see, in a district in Nagaland. So this is a Naga faction. National Socialist Council of Nagaland, Kaplang, NSCNK stands for that. So this is a Naga rebel group, and this is one of the factions of NSCN. The other faction, NSCN IM, is still continuing with the ceasefire which has been in place with the government. So the ceasefire has been breached by this NSCNK. They pulled out of the ceasefire in March 2015. So after 14 years, they pulled out of the ceasefire. So they have attacked the army, and the army pursued them, and this operation was conducted in limited to Indian border only. This has been clarified, because in June 2015, in a similar incident, a surgical strike against NSC and K militants was undertaken by the Indian troops, pursuing them even into Myanmar territory. So we had crossed over the Indian border into Myanmar, because these militant groups, they attack Indian forces in India, and then they run away, cross the border and take refuge in the neighboring country's territory. So we had pursued them even in Myanmar in June 2015, and a surgical strike was done there, and this had been put out in open by the government, which had related some antagonism between the Indian and Myanmar government, because no country wants surgical strikes to be done in their land. So this was the incident, but presently it has been clarified that it was limited to Indian border. So this is a security related issue. Here you can see, this is the Naga district, Mon district, on India-Myanmar border, where this incident took place. Then the next news item is Hafiz Saeed Lashkar a liability, Pakistan foreign minister. So the Pakistan foreign minister was in US, and here he has blamed the US government for the rise of jihad in South Asia and in Pakistan. So Pakistan foreign minister Khwaja Mohammad Asif, he told an audience in New York that Islamabad's cooperation in America's proxy war against Soviet Union during the Cold War era has brought upon the current turmoil on Pakistan, that they are having militants on their territories. Terrorism has taken roots here in Pakistan because of USA. So he says that US had earlier nurtured these terrorists for their fight against the Soviet, and Pakistan had allowed this to happen, and that was a mistake by Pakistan. And he says that President Donald Trump's new policy towards the South Asian region, where he blames Pakistan for terrorism, is not just surprising but disappointing. So this is a statement. He says, don't blame us for the Haqqanis and Hafiz Saeed. He says these were the people who were darling to you just 20-30 years back. So he says that all of them should also take responsibility for the condition of the country presently. He says before Pakistan had joined the war against Soviet Union, Pakistan was a liberal country where people of all faiths and sects could live together. But now it is no longer the case. So this, again, the blame has been put back on US by Pakistan for rise of terrorism. He says we'll need time to eliminate the Haqqanis and Hafiz Saeeds. This is a problem of the US, and we need help from the US for this too now. Then next is, soon you will be able to order diesel online. So the Ministry of Petroleum has announced that they are working towards creating an e-commerce platform in which customers can order diesel online and get it delivered at their doorstep. So the government eventually wants to allow all petroleum products for e-commerce. So this was a decision taken around April 2017. But then the problem, the key challenge to this was safety, because petrol is highly inflammable. So that is why now diesel has been chosen as a fuel, as a model. So because it is not inflammable, it takes a lot of effort for it to catch fire. So that is why diesel would now be the fuel which would be available online through an e-commerce platform. So this initiative has been taken. So far only LPG is delivered at home to consumers, but now otherwise we need, for petrol, diesel, CNG, even engine oils, we need to visit retail outlets. So this is going to change now. They will be delivered at the doorstep. So this has been initiated by the present government. Then next is, Western Ghats throw up a new snake. So new species of earthworms and frogs have been found from Western Ghats this year. Now there is this new species of non-venomous, it's non-poisonous endemic snake, aquatic rhabdops, as it has been named, has been found in northern Western Ghats. So this is a 3 foot long nocturnal snake which hunts for prey underwater. That is why it has been named aquatic rhabdops. So these rhabdops actually are endemic to Western Ghats, and this endemicity is important because means they are, endemicity means they are present in a particular specific geographic location. So here it is the Western Ghats we are talking of. So all these rhabdops snakes are endemic to India only. So this is also a rhabdop snake. Earlier it was considered to be belonging to the same species, but now it has been known it is a different species because not only in its physical features it's different, but also its genetic makeup is different. So this has been found. Then next is, children born of void marriages are legitimate. So this is the ruling of the Supreme Court. Actually, it was the ruling of Madras High Court on which the central government had made an appeal in the Supreme Court, but the Supreme Court has now dismissed this appeal, and it has upheld the decision of Madras High Court that children born of an invalid or void marriage are legitimate and eligible for appointment in government sector on compassionate grounds. So this was a case of railway, in Southern Railway. This was an application filed by a man after the death of his father while at work. So this man did not get the job because he was born out of second marriage of his father, while the first marriage was also there, so it was not legal. So that is why our child of the second marriage cannot be called legitimate. So that is why the government had, the railways actually had not given him the job. But in this High Court order, Madras High Court order, it allowed, and the Supreme Court has also upheld that order. It has also referred to the 2000 Supreme Court judgment in Rameshwari Devi versus State of Bihar case. So even if a marriage is void, children would be legitimate, and they would be entitled to claim share of benefits including family pension, death cum retirement, gratuities. Same way, this is what has been upheld in this case also. Even the Hindu Marriage Act of 1955 specifically mentions that even if the marriage is null and void, any child of such marriage would have been legitimate if the marriage had been valid, is legitimate. So the child would be legitimate. Then next is, India promises support to Syria. So this was the Grand Mufti of Syria Republic who was on visit to India, and this Syrian Republic Grand Mufti has been given assurances of support by India to Syria in its fight against terrorism. It's a war-ravaged country, Syria. It has facing the threat of Islamic State. Even Indians joining Islamic State in the fight, this terror group. So this is also a concern that Indians are traveling to Syria and joining IS. Syria, Iraq. So this was also an issue which has been discussed, and India has assured complete support in fight against terrorism. Then next is, CCS clears internal security scheme. So the Cabinet Committee on Security, headed by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has approved a 25,000 crore internal security scheme. So it is an umbrella scheme for modernization of police force for 2017-18 to 2019-20. So this is a scheme to strengthen the country's law and order mechanism and modernize the police force. So for this, various provisions which have been made under it are for internal security, law and order, women's security, availability of modern weapons, mobility of police forces, logistical support, even hiring of helicopters and e-prison come under it. So this is the complete outlay. You can see the central budget outlay is there of around 10,132 crores for internal security related expenditure, especially for Jammu and Kashmir, northeastern states and left-wing extremism affected states. So this is there. A special central assistance would also be given for extremely affected districts, extremely affected by left-wing extremism. So this is the new initiative which has been introduced. So assistance would be given to states for upgradation of police infrastructure, even forensic science labs and institutions equipments would be upgraded. So the plan is also to have an integrated database, a national database of crime and criminal records. So this should also be there with police stations, is also a an objective. So this is it. Then next is CSIR's biggest global deal stalled. So CSIR, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, we have seen in recent times, we have seen news regarding how this research organization is starved of funds. So it has also committed of securing 10 to 15% of its fund, around 4,000 crore budget, which it has. It wants at least 10 to 15% of it to come through external projects and sources. And one such deal which it had is with Ethiopia. So you can see a company in Ethiopia. This is for development of metal industries, Metal Industries Development Institute. So this company in Ethiopia has signed a $7 million deal. That is around 45 crore deal, a 3-year agreement for technology transfer. So this deal has not been put into effect. So this is a key concern. And the reason being given is that of red tapeism. So it is stuck in the official level. There are concerns, it is said, regarding conversion of foreign currency as such. So this issue has come to the fore. Then next is EPFO gets notice under GST. So the GST intelligence unit has given a notice to Employees Provident Fund Organization. So Employees Provident Fund Organization is actually an organization under Ministry of Labor, EPFO. So it says that, you know, the EPFO is actually exempted from payment of service tax. So this has been in place since April 2016. So since it is exempted from payment of service tax, it is also exempted. This exemption has been extended to it under the GST also. So under GST Act also, it comes under the negative list. So it is exempted from GST as well. But Goods and Services Tax Intelligence Unit has given it a notice saying that it is defaulting on payment of service tax and it wants to examine the Provident Funds Department's records till 2016-17. So this has been refuted. Even the Labour Ministry has asked the Finance Ministry to extend this relaxation retrospectively and look into the matter. So this issue has come here now. Then next is India woos small and medium enterprises in Britain. So the Indian High Commission in Britain has begun an initiative to encourage small and medium enterprises in Britain to invest in India. So there is this Access India also. A provision which has been made, a platform which has been made to have ease of doing business for these small and medium sized British businesses to invest in India. So it says that they have huge potential, especially in sectors like defense, pharmaceutical and food sector. So these small and medium enterprises, if they are given the opportunity, then every product, it says, Indian High Commission says, every product in UK has a potential to do well in India because the market is only so big in India. So if they invest in India, India would also benefit and the businesses would also flourish. So this initiative is being taken now by the Indian High Commission in London. Then next is Serum Institute's pentavalent rotavirus vaccine is safe and efficacious. So the rotavirus vaccine Rotasil, which is manufactured by Pune-based Serum Institute of India, has been tested on children during phase 3 trials and it has been found to be safe and effective. So it has been found to have nearly 39% efficiency in children with severe rotavirus cases and 59% efficiency against very severe forms of rotavirus diarrhea. So you can see the vaccine targets all 5 rotavirus serotypes. So this is important. In 2013 itself, if you look at the number of rotavirus deaths that occurred in India, it's around 47,000, which accounts for 22% of all rotavirus deaths in the world. So India has a huge burden of rotavirus deaths. That's why this vaccination is also important. You should know that even under the universal immunization program, which is there of the Indian government, rotavirus vaccine has also been included in select districts as such with effect from 2016. So this is there. So it's actually the Bharat Biotech which launched the first rotavirus vaccine in 2015. So this vaccine, however, is only for one serotype. It contains only one serotype, but the Rotasil rotavirus vaccine of Serum Institute of India has all 6 serotypes, all 5 rotavirus serotypes. So this is important. You can see phase 3 trial took place. The 3 doses of the vaccine were given to children at 6, 10 and 14 weeks of age. So this is how immunization also takes place. This is a periods of immunization for small children. So at that time only, during this time, this rotavirus vaccine was provided to Tassil, and the results have been shown that it is effective and safe. This is the news. Even there are other rotavirus vaccines apart from Rotasil of Serum Institute, Bharat Biotech rotavirus, and also GlaxoSmithKline has its rotavirus, which is again monovalent. Monovalent means only for one serotype. There is also Merck's vaccine for rotavirus. This is contains all five human rotavirus serotypes. So this is the news. Here the details regarding rotavirus is also given. So it's a leading cause of severe gastroenteritis among young children and is responsible for approximately 37% of diarrhea related child deaths worldwide. Symptoms are same: severe diarrhea, vomiting, fever, abdominal pain. So these are symptoms. Additional symptoms may be even loss of appetite and dehydration. The vaccine, as you see, Rotasil, this is for all five serotypes of rotavirus. Also, it will remain stable for 2 years at a temperature of 37 degrees Celsius and for 6 months at 40 degrees Celsius. So this is also of significance. So this is regarding Rotasil, and this is regarding rotavirus being included in vaccination. You can see here. So number of deaths also here, it is shown that almost 2/3 of all rotavirus deaths in 2013 means around 10 countries account for these 2/3 deaths. India has 22% of this burden. And you can see in 2016, India's first indigenous rotavirus vaccine was launched as part of universal immunization program. So this was Bharat Biotech rotavirus vaccine, third vaccine available globally. After GSK, Merck, Bharat Biotech came, and now the news is that even the safety of this Rotasil rotavirus of Serum Institute of India has been proved. And you should know about Mission Indradhanush too. It was launched in December 2014. So it is aimed at ensuring that all children under the age of 2 years and pregnant women are fully immunized. So rotavirus has also been included under this. You can see in 4 states and another 5 states have been added. So gradually vaccine would be available throughout the country. So this is regarding Mission Indradhanush. You can see launched in 2014. So you should know about this. Indradhanush means 7 colors of the rainbow. So these are the 7 vaccine preventable diseases which have been covered under this Mission Indradhanush: diphtheria, whooping cough, tetanus, poliomyelitis, and tuberculosis, measles, and hepatitis B. Then the next news item is researchers find fossils on Zealandia. So this is regarding Zealandia. This is a new continent which has been discovered. We have discussed it in around Feb 2017 too. So it was a submerged continent. You can see the image shown here. So as the name comes from Zealand. So New Zealand, you can see New Zealand is the country here. And this is actually the entire continent. So here you can see this is New Caledonia, again an island region. So this entire continent, it's actually one complete continent. This region is to the fore on the surface, which is a nation, New Zealand. But this is also a landmass, which is contiguous landmass. And this has been called a separate continent now, Zealandia as it has been named. So this now, the present news regarding this Zealandia is that it has been seen that there are fossils present on Zealandia too. So actually, you should know about this. It is submerged more than 1 kilometer under water. And researchers have affiliated to International Ocean Discovery Program in USA. In collaboration, scientists from 23 countries had done a 9-week expedition to drill into Zealandia and bring back samples. And when these samples were brought in and studied, it has been discovered that there are microscopic shells of organisms that live in warm, shallow seas, and spores and pollens from land plants which have been found in these. So fossils have been found, and this reveals that the geography and climate of Zealandia was dramatically different in the past. Means it was not submerged forever. So earlier it was above sea level 2. So this is Zealandia. Presently 94% of it is underwater. So you should know about this too. This has been a prominent news in 2017. So these are the news items. Thank you.